Hello students, welcome to our channel Learning Notebook. In today's video, we will do part 1 of chapter Trigonometry. In this part 1, we will learn trigonometric ratios. So let's start and first understand what is trigonometry. Trigonometry means the science of measuring triangles. The word trigonometry is derived from Greek words trigonon and metron. The word trigonon means a triangle and metron means measure. So trigonometry is the branch of mathematics which deals with the measurement of sides and angles of a triangle. Students, in class 10, we will only deal with right angle triangles. Trigonometry is very useful in measuring height and distances. For example, here the girl sitting on a balcony can measure the width of river between building and temple by using trigonometry. Let's take another example. The boy on the ground can measure the height of hot air balloon from the ground by using trigonometry. Even engineers and scientists use trigonometrical concepts to find out distances of stars and planets from the Earth. Students, in this part, we will study 6 trigonometric ratios of the sides of a right triangle with respect to its acute angle. Let's consider a right angle triangle ABC with angle B equals to 90 degree. The side AC opposite to the right angle is called hypotenuse. Students, let's consider angle A equals to theta. Now the confusion is which side is perpendicular and which side is base. So if we are defining trigonometric ratios for acute angle theta, then the side on which both 90 degree and theta lies is the base. So here base equals to side AB. Now side opposite to angle A is the perpendicular. So here perpendicular equals to side BC. Students, it is very important to understand base, perpendicular and hypotenuse with respect to acute angle. Now let's consider angle C as theta. Hypotenuse AC remains same, that is the side opposite to right angle. Students, the side on which both 90 degree and theta lie is the base. So here base equals to side BC and side opposite to angle C is the perpendicular. Therefore here perpendicular is side BA. Let's consider a right angle triangle ABC with base equals to AB, perpendicular equals to BC, hypotenuse equals to AC and angle A equals to theta. So 6 trigonometric ratios for acute angle theta can be defined as sine theta equals to perpendicular upon hypotenuse. Second, cosine theta equals to base upon hypotenuse. Cosine theta is also called as cos theta. Next is tangent theta or tan theta equals to perpendicular upon base. Fourth ratio is cosecant theta or cosec theta. It is equal to hypotenuse upon perpendicular. Next is secant theta or sec theta. It is equal to hypotenuse upon base. And the last ratio is cotangent theta or cot theta equals to base upon perpendicular. Students, as you can see, there are 3 sides of a triangle. So by combination, only 6 trigonometric ratios are possible. and the mathematicians named these ratios as sin theta, cos theta, tan theta, cosec theta, sec theta, and cot theta. Now, the biggest problem is how to remember these trigonometric ratios. I will tell you two ways to remember. First way is in Hindi language and second way is in English. Let's see the first way. Pandit Badri Prasad, Har Har Bole, Sona Chandi Tole. Now, just take the first letter of all these words. First column represents P upon H equals to sin theta. Second column represents B upon H equals to cos theta. And third column represents P upon B equals to tan theta. Now, let's see the second way, which is in English. Some people have curly brown hair that are painted black. Again, just take the first letter of all the words. So, first row represents sin theta equals to P upon H. Second row represents cos theta equals to B upon H. And third row represents tan theta equals to P upon B. So students, you can use any of these two methods to remember trigonometric ratios. Let's do a theorem related to trigonometric ratios. Theorem says, trigonometric ratios are same for same angle. In this triangle ABC, trigonometric ratio of acute angle theta remains same if angle theta remains same. To understand this, let's draw PM perpendicular to AB. Now, let's extend triangle ABC such that angle ANQ equals to 90 degree. So, theorem says that trigonometric ratio of triangle AMP equals to trigonometric ratios of triangle ABC equals to trigonometric ratios of triangle ANQ since their angle theta remain same. Now, let's prove this theorem. Angle PAM equals to angle CAB equals to theta. Angle AMP equals to angle ABC equals to 90 degree. Corresponding angles of triangle AMP and triangle ABC are equal. Therefore, both the triangles are similar triangles. This implies ratios of sides of similar triangles are equal. Therefore, AP by AC equals to AM by AB equals to PM by CB. This implies PM by AP equals to CB by AC. But students, PM by AP equals to CB by AC equals to sin theta. Similarly, AM by AP equals to AB by AC equals to cos theta. And PM by AM equals to CB by AB equals to tan theta. This shows that the values of trigonometric ratios are independent of length of sides of triangle if angle remains the same. Hence, we have proved the theorem. There are few more things to understand to solve trigonometry questions. First is sin theta whole square equals to sin square theta, and not equal to sine theta square, because theta square is the square of theta. Next, sine theta whole cube equals to sine cube theta and not equal to sine theta cube. Students, this applies not only to sine theta but to all those 6 trigonometric ratios. Now, sine theta inverse is not equal to sine minus 1 theta. It has different meaning. We will study this in higher classes. Now, students, do you remember Pythagoras theorem, which is equal to AC square equals to AB square plus BC square? Since we are going to deal with right angle triangles, Pythagoras theorem is very useful in solving trigonometry questions. So, students, in this video, we learned trigonometric ratios. Now, in the next part, we will study relationship between trigonometric ratios. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, then do hit the like button. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel Learning Notebook and make sure to press the bell icon. Thank you. Bye-bye. See you in the next video.